हेलो ऑल, आई एम पुनश्री पाटिल फ्रॉम AISSMS IOIT कॉलेज डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी पुणे. सो टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस द डिसीजन कंट्रोल स्टेटमेंट्स इन पायथॉन. सो इन पायथॉन लूप्स आर यूज टू इटरेट द रिपीटेडली ओवर द ब्लॉक ऑफ कोड इन ऑर्डर टू चेंज द वे ऑफ लूप इज एग्जीक्यूटेड फ्रॉम इट्स विजुअल बिहेवियर. Control statements are used. So control statements are used to control the flow of execution of the loop based on a condition. So there are many types of control statements in Python. So we have to discuss it. So types of control statements are the selection or conditional control statements in which if else, ladder if else is used. Then basic loop structure and iterative control structure in which we have to use the for loop and while loops. And in jump control statement, we have to use the break, continue and pass statements. So in selection or conditional control statement, it is used to execute only the selected set of statements. In basic loop and structure and iterative control structure, we have to use the set of statements repeatedly. And in jump control statements, these statements are allows to program to change the order of execution of the statements. So first we have to see the selection or conditional control statements. So here are the types of selection or conditional branching statements. So if else, nested if, and if else if statements. Okay, so first we have to see the if statements. So if statement is used to test the particular condition, and if the condition is true, it executes the block of the code known as the if block. And the condition of the if statement can be valid logical expression which can be either evaluated true or false. So here is the syntax for the if condition. If, then you have to check the test the expression. Here is the flowchart for this if condition. Then here is the next one is the if else statements. So if else statement execute the group of statements when the test expression is true, otherwise it will be executed another group of the statements. So here is the syntax. In if condition, you have to check the condition. If it is true, then execute the statements of block, otherwise it executes the else part. Here is the flowchart for this if else condition. If the condition is true, then statement block 1 is executed, otherwise statement block 2 is executed. Okay, so next one is the nested if condition. So nested means we have to use the if loop within if loops. So nested if statements are if statement inside the another if statements. So here is the syntax for if condition, if nested if condition. If you have to check the next condition, then it is nested another if condition, then end of the nested loop. Then next one is the if else condition. It is used to check the multiple conditions only if the given condition is false. It is similar to if else statement, and but there is only one difference where else will not check the condition, but in ELIF statement we will check the else condition. It is similar to the if else, but ELIF statement evaluate the multiple conditions. So here is the syntax. In if condition, you have to check the condition. Then in else if condition, you have to also check the condition. Or the, if it is true, then the statements will be executed. Otherwise, else statement will be executed. The next one is the looping statements or iterative structure statements. So here we have to see the two types of loops available: while loop and for loop. So first one is the while loops. So while loop in Python is used to execute a block of statement as long as the given condition is true, and when the condition is false, the control will come out of the loops. So condition is checked every time at the beginning of the loop in the while condition. So syntax is the we have to use the while is the keyword, then you have to write down the condition, then colon. So here is the flowchart for this is also available. So next one is the for loops. So the for loop is used to run the block of code for the certain number of times. It is used to iterate over any sequence such as list, tuple and string. So here is the syntax for that: for value in sequence, and then you have to write down the number of statements for the executing for loop. So next one is the break statements. So break statement is used to terminate the execution of the nearest enclosing loop in which it appears. So break statement is used for the for loop as well as the while loop. When the compiler encounters break statement, the control pass to the statement that follows the loop in the break statement appears. So syntax for that is you have to use only the break as the keyword. Here is the example of the demonstration of the break statement. So here we have to use the while condition I is equal to 1, while we have to check here I is less than equal to 10. If it is as if condition, we have to check the I is equal to 5, then we break condition we have to use, and then we increment the I operator. So we have to get the output from 1 to 5. The next one is the continue statements. So like the break statement, the continue statement can also only appear in the body of the loops. When the compiler encounter a continue statement, then the rest of the statements in the loops are skipped and the control is unconditionally transferred to the loop continuation portion of the nearest enclosing loop. So syntax for that is we have to use the continue word. Then here is the program for the continue statements. We have to take the range function from 1 to 11 and we have to check the condition. If I is equal to 5, then we have to use the continue, then print the I element. So we will get the output 1 to 10 numbers, skip the 5 because we have to check here if I is equal to 5. So next one is the pass statements. So pass statement is used when the statement is required synthetically, but there is no command or code has to be executed. It is simply used for the null operation or the no operation. Okay, we have to use the syntax for that is the pass as the keyword. Thank you.